1, 2, 1, 2, 3, and...
Pablo,
don't be discouraged. The man, he ain't so hard to understand.
Pablo,
if you try now, I know that you can lend a helping hand.
All right, it's another edition of Pablo and the Man. This is Thursday. It's kind of rainy out today, so we started over at the stone patio we're doing, and we got the fire pit lit up. It's looking good. We'll have to show you when we get back over there, but it started to rain and get wet, and it's gonna rain some more today, so we decided that we wanted to do an inside gig. So we're over here at 2223 Grace Street. Pablo Casso, look at that mustache.
Oi.
And Boy Wonder. And so we're working inside. And I got a call from Jan and John, and they want to remove this fireplace. So we have a little of knowledge in that, as we took down that little heating thing in Pasadena, which was not as fortified as this fireplace. This fireplace is like an old heaterator, I think they were called. So the inside of it is not a firebox. The inside of it is all metal, and it's got some pipes in it. And the pipes actually come out on these vents right here. On one side is one vent, and on the other side is another. So what this fireplace did was, because it was kind of open, was it sucked up the heat, and then it blew it out the sides to warm the house up. This house is pretty old, I'm not sure exactly, but maybe the 20s or 30s. So the first thing that we have to do is we have to go up in the attic and start working our way down. So, I'll have Kaylin, Boy Wonder, show you, but right now we have to go up in here with buckets and jackhammer out the top part of the fireplace. We had to get some planks to throw across the other planks on the attic so we can slide the buckets over and take the first part out with the buckets. Kaylin's doing a great job jackhammering. Pablo's loading the buckets, sliding them over here to me. I grab them from the ladder and I take them down and dump them outside. So when Kaylin comes back down, I'll show you our pile and what we've got so far. So we come through here and we come out here. And we throw everything in our pile. So, most of it's a bunch of broken up rock, brick and concrete, but we did get a few of the flue liners out. So this is where, you know, smoke actually comes up through these flue liners. So, I don't know, I think that's about 20 buckets. Pablo says we have about 60 more to go to get into the attic part done. And then we'll plastic off the house and move a couple of things and start working on the bricks down below the ceiling. But right now we gotta stay up top. So we're taking a little break, getting some fresh air, and then we'll get back to it. I guess I got the easy part, because I'm down low. Those guys are up top. We're gonna try to save these bricks. There's some really cool clinker bricks in here, and these are old cool bricks. So we're gonna do our best when we get down here to at least try not to break too many of them, and then I'm not sure who, but somebody can try to chip the mortar off and maybe reuse these bricks here at this house. I know that John had mentioned doing a little brick walkway outside, so we'll see what we can salvage. But that's our gig for today. So tomorrow gotta go on another one. And I don't know, maybe we'll come back here Saturday or tomorrow afternoon or whatever. And you know, I don't wanna keep this house destroyed or torn up too long. We're gonna have to move this cabinet. We might have to move this piano. So those are some of the interesting, fun things that Pablo and the man get to work on. It's not always creation. Sometimes it's destruction, demolition, tingao. Anyway, that's it for the first shot of our indoor fireplace demo removal deal. So thanks for watching. Have a good day. Be safe. Stay dry. Ding dong.
Halfway down, well, almost halfway. Got our chipping gun, our hammer, and we're just going to town, nice and slow, knocking everything down. And then taking the stuff back out. So, we got it all down. That right here is one course above the ceiling. So there's a tiny gap on this side. We don't want to take it any more down from the top. So since we're close to the top of the ceiling, we can get it from the inside of the house instead of up here in the attic. So I'm just finishing up, cleaning up as much of this crap as we can. Chimney down later. I don't know if they plan on doing it today, but that's where we're at. Cleaning up, trying to get this as best as we can. Extremely dusty and dirty up here. Oh yeah. So, yep, that's our. Okay.
Hello! 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 Oh boy, raining out. Rainy Danny. Anyway, we're inside. The other day, Caitlin and Pablo were up here taking out the top of this thing, and now we're taking out the bottom. This is an old school, like a heat-o-lator type of fireplace. It's pretty big, dude, and heavy duty. So the fire would come up, come through these holes, and then it would be distributed out through some vents that were on the side of the brick. So we're kicking ass. Pablo's the hammer. He's working that full Milwaukee like a badass. And we're taking the stuff and we're putting it in wheelbarrows and we're pushing it out and dumping it. And we're trying not to make a mess and be too dusty, but we're kind of making a mess of being dusty. But that's part of the game. They knew that. So we're trying to save that part right there because we got to tooth out and run that brick wall back across here when this is all out, the hearth and everything. And then come this way. You'll see that's like the back wall of the kitchen with nice tile and stuff. So we don't wanna damage that. We don't wanna mess that up. So we're gonna not mess it up and be careful and keep doing our thing. So you see where that wall is over there? We gotta bring that across. So Pablo's doing a great job. So is Kaylin. So we gotta at some point tooth out, pick out some of these bricks like this one, 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 so that we can bring it across and tie it in. And hopefully we'll be able to use some of those old bricks that are out in the pile and do it and kind of make the mortar look the same and try to make it look like it never happened. But we're not there yet. We're still in the demo. So back to demo. Okay, we're trying hard. There's our pile. Okay, well, it rained today pretty good. I don't know, maybe an hour or so ago. We lost power, but, you know, we couldn't use the jackhammer anymore. So, that's all right. We're cleaning up our stuff, and we will probably come back here tomorrow because it's raining pretty hard, and I don't know if there's anything else that we can do outside with the amount of rain that we got today. Everything will need a little time to dry out, so hopefully the rain will fizzle out tonight. That's what I'm hearing, and we can do something else. But tomorrow we need to come in. You know, we got everything out. We didn't damage the other side in the kitchen area. We need to tape off really good, and we're probably gonna have to take our Makita or some type of saw and notch out as you can see where that wall was tied in on that side and that side, so that we can continue that wall across and make it look like it was always there and never had this big fireplace here. We still have to work on the hearth and the floor of the fireplace, but without power and the jackhammer, it's pointless. So we're just about done. We're gonna lock it up, call it a day. Got one more gate to go look at. I think the gate's got power to it so I can get to their house. If not, I'm gonna go grab a bale of hay and head home. So that's it from the fireplace demo. Pablo the Man, thanks for watching. Okay, it's Wednesday. Pablo and the Man over at Jan and John's house, but John split, went on a road trip up to Idaho, helping his family move back up to Chico. So Jan's here with Brody. I don't know where Baxter's at, but anyway, this was where the giant fireplace was, right? Last week we got up top and got the above ceiling attic part out. Yesterday we started putting or taking down from the chimney, which we did. And today we finished removing the rest of the back of the chimney and the hearth and the front of it. So after we did all that, we put down some of the wood that we had used up in the rafters, and we put some plywood back here to temporarily kind of make this less of a hazard for four or two legged people, friends, whatever. And so we toothed out here on each edge of where these fireplace connected. So later, after I show you this, you can see the giant pile of debris. So Jan and John are gonna go through the bricks and they're going to try to salvage any of the good ones that are out there, clean them up so we can reuse them. There's some clinkers and some other ones. There's a lot of stuff that's no good, but there's a lot of stuff that is good. So, and that's not gonna happen overnight. It's gonna be a little bit of a process because there's a shit ton of bricks out there. So once that gets dialed in and they get as many bricks as they can, we'll come back and we'll finish this wall all the way across. You can look behind here and kind of see how this brick was not detailed or finished. It was just a wall to support the drywall for the kitchen. So we've got it lined up pretty doggone good to when we come back here, make it look like it never happened. So anyway, you know, we made some dust. We did our best, but we made some dust. So we'll have to, Jan will undust or whatever.
Send in the maid.
Send in the maid. And let's look at our pile. Oh my goodness. What an outstanding pile of rubble and bricks. And this was actually the fireplace. It's called the heaterator, right? So this is the whole metal deal that sat there. There was a post right here, so it was kind of a two-sided fireplace. It's not super heavy, but it's pretty stout. This is all the steel that was in it. Angle iron, bunch of steel in it. Heavy duty too. These are old school. I think this thing was, this house was built in the 50s. We got some flue liners still that we saved. Jan may make some pots out of those and put them in the yard. And there's the pile to go through, you know, and find bricks that, you know, are good. This one's a little ding, but there's a lot of them in here that have a good face to them. They just need to be cleaned off. Wow, that was fast. Doesn't always work like that. Anyway, I think there's probably maybe 100, maybe more good bricks in there. Just gotta go through and clean them up and put them in a pile, and then we'll reuse them. And if we need to get some more, I know a place where I can get real used brick that'll match this pretty good. So when they're ready, we'll put everything back and try to make it look like it never happened. John
is a wood guy. He's got a shop back here. I'm sure he'll put the flooring in, make it look nice. So we're officially checking out here, going back to our fireplace that we're building, not tearing down tomorrow, to rock and roll. So anyway, we put the armoire, or I don't know, that's not an armoire. It's a nice old antique China hutch. Thank you for that. And so we put that back to kind of camo it, and it did make this room a lot bigger. Gotta say, there's way more space here now, and they still have a cool fireplace over there. So, two thumbs up. Thanks for watching Pablo and the Man. Don't forget there, Pablo. Keep an eye on that mustache. It's growing every day. It's really looking nice.
So here we are setting up some plastic. We still have to demo a little bit and take out a beam up there and some bricks at the top to kind of tie it all in and to make it right. So we're kind of putting up our plastic right now, taping down the floor, making sure everything's set up so when we start jackhammering the top and making cuts that our dust doesn't go everywhere in the house. It kind of stays contained. We also put a vacuum on to kind of suck in some of that dust. And yeah, we're just getting that all set up right now. And then we'll start doing our demo. And then once we get all our demo done, we'll end up taking down the plastic and start putting up the wall. Now we're starting to demo that top section up there so that we can replace some of those boards that's ceiling. Making some cuts, cleaning some stuff on the floor. Just trying to get everything set and prepped for when we bring in all the bricks and the cement and we start laying everything. So as you can see, not a whole lot of demo stuff since we already demoed it all out last time. Just a few little things that we had to make some cuts on and get right. We did have mask on because it was pretty dusty in there, and it's good to, you know, make sure you're not breathing in all that crap. And then we took down the plastic and started bringing in bricks and staging them there, getting ready to go.
Okay, we're back over at John and Jan's on Grace Street. I don't know, a while ago we came here and went up through the attic and tore down a chimney fireplace that was here that had a hearth that came out. And dude, we were up in the rafters with buckets coming down the little hole and stuff. Anyway, we left a big pile of bricks out there, which John and Jan have cleaned them and got them all ready for us. So we have brought them in so they can dry, and we were able to get a beam out of here that was in there. This morning, Pablo went up top and found some nails and pulled it, got it out. We have a couple that are dinged, but we can clean them up. We have enough brick. And if we don't, I know a place where we can get some that are very, very close to this real, real used old brick. So I have Riverside plastic cement and sand to try and recreate this mortar rather than trying to use spec mix, which is a pre-blended stuff. We want to try to make this look as old and like it was never there as possible. I brought my saw because this Pablo and I were looking at this. It's got long bricks and it's got some short bricks. So there's some shorties in here. And as this fireplace had come out, it was beautiful, but now that it's gone and we're coming straight, as we came across to this corner, we realized that to make this wall straight, which that big piece of furniture, which displays a lot of stuff, I'm sure will be here, but to make this straight, we needed to come to this corner right here. So in order for us to be able to hide the cut over on this side and have this full brick, we trimmed these bricks right here on this edge. So now we'll take this, and then we'll take our saw and we'll cut one here. And then on our next one up, we'll just have a little cut here. but it's way better to hide it over here and have this be full all the way across. So we've got that cut ready to go. Tomorrow, rain's over, we'll start to build this back up. And it's not a race, see how far we get. There's also a little work to do out front or out back, a couple little walkways. So today was Monday, fun day. We'll be back tomorrow. Bye. Started this morning, made our mud, and started laying. Pablo started laying this corner. I started running this area in. And so it's probably almost noon, and we need to start to clean up and detail what we've laid. Our mortar starts to get kind of hard. So I'm going through here right now and sticking it. And then I'm coming in with a wire brush. And I'm wire brushing the joints, and then I will hit it with a hairbrush, a little horsehair brush, to get all the snot off of it, and then I can go ahead and sponge it, clean all the bricks up real good, and then I got to clean the floor up, get all this debris out of here, and then set the ladder up for tomorrow to go up there. So it's kind of a process. You make a mess, you clean it up, you make a mess again. But in the end, it's the finished product that counts, and that's the way to do it. So it turns out the best. Right, Pablo?
Yes,
sir. Okie dokie, Tuesday. Dry day today, it was pretty nice out. We were in here, we had gotten our bricks in, and we were able to get this much up today. So we, you know, laid everything, then you gotta detail it, sponge it, clean it. We're able to get a little planter fixed outside as well. And so tomorrow we'll set up, we have two ladders here with a plank. Pablo and I think we can get up there and grab the bricks as we need to and get that top part done. And then we have to fill up all the way over to that corner over there. So I think we can have that done by noon, and then hopefully we can start. There's a little walkway out, a little walkway and a step out in the back, and try to knock that out too. But we were able to use some of the, I have to say, the Jan, the owner here, did a really good job cleaning all the bricks that we tore out a few months ago, maybe longer, I can't remember. But we got some cool clinker brick, so we're putting in some of these cool clinker bricks every so often, like the cool clinker bricks were put in over here. I'm not sure exactly when this brick was done, but it's pretty old. And we also used Riverside plastic cement with sand in order to try and match this mortar the best we can. And make it look old. Making stuff that's brand new look like it's 80 years old is the one of the hardest things to do, but we're working hard to accomplish that look. The mortar still has to cure and dry. You can see it's still wet, but I truly believe when it's all done, it'll blend really nicely. And maybe Boy Wonder has a picture of this fireplace before, the way it came out with this pose, I'm not sure, but this corner's coming out nice. Like we talked about, we tried not to have a little tiny piece in there, so we kept this joint a little wide, but I think when everything dries out, it's the least of two evils than having a cut there. So Pablo's doing a nice job here. I threw in the middle part, and that's it. Back in the morning for more action. More action. Looking good.
All right, so right now we're gonna be mixing up our cement. We're not using spec mix because, like my dad said, we gotta make it look old. So to do that, we gotta use the older Riverside cement and mix it with sand and not use the pre-blended stuff. So we're using a bag and a half of sand with about four shovels of Riverside cement. So let's get it in there. One. Sand's kind of wet already, so I don't have to put that much water in it, but gotta put a little bit. We do another half bag of this. Boom. One more. Four. Now, before adding water, we're gonna stir it up, mix all the sand up with the cement. Because if you try to put water in right now, it's just gonna clump up the cement. And you're gonna have a bunch of clumps in your cement. And that means you're not gonna be able to use your grout bag, and it's gonna be a pain in the butt to lay. This will be all clumpy, so you kind of want to go through and mix the cement up with the sand before you add any water. Just a little trick, because if you didn't know that, you'd just be like, oh yeah, let me add water, and then you'd be like, well, that didn't work right. Why is it so clumpy? It's not working. It's because gotta mix up the sand and the cement together. Alright, so now we got it all mixed up. This guy you could tuck in right down there. You just boom and they stick. So now we'll add water. Usually I hit the edges Get it all off the edge. Not too much, because you don't want to get it too wet. You want to have a right mixture, so better to start off slow with it than to put a bunch of water in it and have it be too wet. Just go back and forth, slowly mixing up everything nice and good. Then I usually pull everything back this side to one side, and then I'll fill up the other side and pull it back. Do that maybe two or three times, and then you'll be good to go. Have a good batch. So I'm gonna knock everything down, clean the wheelbarrow a little bit. That's pretty good. It's a little wet, so I might add a little more cement in there to kind of stiffen it up a little bit. Right now we're gonna add some concrete adhesive. This basically just helps it give a little bit more of a bite and stick to the mud. So we'll throw some of that in there. And we're gonna mix that in. And then I will throw a little more concrete in. And when you're mixing it, you don't want to really see any, like, see how it's little dry spots there? You want to mix through and make sure that everything is mixed nicely. There's no dry spots or it's not lumpy. And then when I sprinkle this on to stiffen it up, kind of just all around so that there's not a big clump in one spot. Just kind of makes it a little easier to mix up. And always make sure you clean your shovel, because if you let it sit too long, it's gonna stick and it's gonna be hard to get off. So I always hose it down. Hit it while it's wet and you'll make your cleaning process later a lot easier. And then there's any sort of spots that you see when you're mixing on the ground, you can hit them when they're wet or when they're still not hard, and you'll be good. And then you go back through, hit it with your trowel, double check. You got all the sides and everything. Make sure you get any little bumps and lumps. I think we're good. We'll take them back in. Beep, beep, beep. Oh, I'm on.
Oh, okay, am I on?
Am I talking or not? Mm-hmm. Yeah? All right. Well, my mud's almost gone off this board, but I'm running this stuff in through here. Then I'll work on the corner to the top, rack it up. And then we got to go with a couple more courses over up in here. So, yeah, just trucking along. Every time you get up higher, you got to get the mud up here, the bricks up here, everything up here. So, the higher you go, it just takes a little more time and effort, but we're ding-donging it. Whoop. I'm going to need you to cut me some more sixes pretty soon, Caleb.
Okay. All right, so now we're going to start detailing the wall. Throw my gloves on because concrete's dirty and it dries out your skin and it's kind of nasty. So we're going under and up. Alright, so first off we're going to use is our joint scraper. Looks like a little triangle, and you basically just run it in the joints and you just scrape out a little bit, not a whole lot, just a little bit. Kind of push it in as you're going. Right? You just kind of scrape a little bit out, which saves you time when you're going through and wire brushing. If you don't have a little joiner, don't have this guy, then I use the back of my wire brush and I do the same thing. I just push it in and go like that. Does the same thing. Some say it works better. Like my dad, he says it works better if you use the back of the brush. So that's the old school way. New school, they got the little joiner. But yep, you just go through, hit all your joints, kind of push it in, scrape a little bit. Just saves you time. If there's any holes like that, I'll just take some mud from another spot and push it in and then go over. Just push it in. Boom. And yep, just hit all the spots. Hit all the joints. Okay. Once you got it there, then you go back through and you wire brush a little bit. Wire brush. Try to make it nice and clean. Try to hit the little edge right here. And yep, that's how you detail it. That's how you detail. Not a rush, take your time. Make sure you try to get everything. You see any spots on the brick, you can hit the bricks too. And yeah, just go through little by little. All right, that's it. I'm gonna keep detailing. Over and out.
Everybody, Wednesday, Wednesday afternoon, kind of cleaning up, finishing up, started Monday here, it was kind of rainy, got ourselves set up, and then yesterday we got up to a certain height, so today we finished filling up our corner and running our bricks back, threw in some clinkers. When you look down, the joist looks good. Some of these bricks are different sizes. And there was a giant fireplace here before that went all the way around in brick, but the leveling and lining everything else up, I think looks great. When these bricks have a chance to dry and that mortar dries thoroughly and lightens up, they'll look great. We did do some cutting when we were preparing here, so I might get some acid and give it a light acid wash tomorrow. Put a roll of paper there and hit it while I have my ladder and stuff here. And then out front, when we tore down this fireplace, I told you what a good job Jan did on cleaning the bricks. Well, look at all these bricks, all these little planters of bricks that she has laying here and setting here, which are pretty cool to divide the bark and the grass and give you paths. And some of the old fire brick were here as steps, but they weren't set in concrete and they weren't grouted. So, yeah, let's step on them right now. We just did them. Now they're set in concrete and they have mortar in between them. So when you step on them, they're not gonna move and tip and be a hazard possibly. So we dialed those in. Tomorrow, we're going into the backyard for a little step and walkway, herringbone. That's it for today from the man and Pablo. The man, Pablo, the man. Okay. Well, here we are wrapping it up over here at John and Jan's. Today we did this brick patio, excuse me, brick walkway. And we got to, you know, be creative, catch the vibe, do something cool. John and Jan had these rocks that looked like hearts. So as we made this herringbone walkway, we put a few of these stone hearts in the concrete. Later when this dries, I can clean this a little bit with some acid. There's a little film on it, but so we got some hearts in there, and then we created this little step for them to get up, and we had a few other hearts, so we put three more
Stone Hearts. And then back in the day, Jan lived somewhere where there was a field, and she would go out and collect pieces of glass and broken things that were out in this field. So she had a couple buckets of them. I dumped them out and decided right here for this step I would find a bunch of old cool pieces of tile and put them in there to kind of, I don't know, create something a little different. She can look at them. There's a seashell in there. There's, I don't know, all kinds of different little goodies, some marbles, some things that we found. So we put them in there. So we're done here now. We've got inside done, outside done, wrapping it up, going back to Mount Rubidoux tomorrow. So cool. We like it, right, Pablo?
Beautiful.
Pablo the man.
Boom.
Pablo and the man. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo. Happy holidays. Merry Christmas. Hope you're on the nice list.
He's in the neck for everybody.
He's in the neck.